Hey there, this is Tim from Twice Circled, and welcome to episode 19 of the official Big Pharma video blog. The latest Big Pharma update is going to come out later this week, and by the time you watch this vlog, it should already be out. And it contains three things that I'm going to show off in this video blog. Those things are, there's a new rating system for some challenges, so a new way in terms of, I should say ranking system. There's a new way of attaining the expert and master ranks, which I think will mix up the gameplay a little bit, should force the player to play in a slightly different way to currently where it's all about just going as quick as possible. I will show you that in a moment. The next thing is Crossroads. They are finally here. So you don't just have T-junctions splitting about three directions. You now have Crossroads, or four ways, whatever you want to call them. And these are really useful for a few things. You can just use them as a 1-3 or a 3-1 splitter, but you can also use them to cross belts over each other. And actually, the mind kind of boggles at the possibilities. There's more possibilities than you think to use that to your advantage. And the third thing is some new AI. And hopefully the AI will actually give me a run for my money in this game. It's still not perfect. There's still stuff I'd like to add. But, you know, it's just a little... I'm making it a little bit better every time I do it. And it's something that I have to kind of just iterate on. I'm going to have a go on one of these quick start challenges because I would like to get to some kind of higher level cures. I play way too much of the first half an hour of the game. And I really want to play a bit more of the game this time. So, without further ado, which one should we play? I think I'm just going to go for quick draw because it's kind of... it's a shame that I've already got the standard challenge. I kind of want to show you how that works. I could have a go at this. I'm just going to do quick draw, and I'll see how far I get. Twice but circled, Chan. I like Chan. You'll notice making use of the thing that I added in the last update, which was it remembers your CEO. And, you know, I'm going to turn edge scrolling off because I never use it. Right, does that work? Look at that, it works. There we go, I've just shown off two things from the last video. Right, okay. So the first thing is this rating system. Oh, sorry, I keep saying rating, ranking system. It's because I've got it bloody written down next to me as rating, but I should write it as ranking. Okay, look at this. You know, normally there's three bars at the bottom and one bar at the top, depending on how many challenge conditions there are. Here, there is three bars at the top and one bar at the bottom. You know what that means? They're switched around. So now, you have different magnitudes of the goal to earn the standard expert and master ranks, but within a fixed time. So I have 7 years. If I earn 3 million, I will get the standard rank. If I continue playing, then you can... if you get to 9 million, I'll get the expert rank. And then 25 million for the master rank in 7 years. I don't think I can do that, and I just... The master rank was never meant to be, like, done by everybody, basically. It was always meant to be that thing that the real, kind of, aficionados of the game can get. And, like, lots of people are managing master rank, so, you know, I might revisit some of the challenges, existing challenges, but I haven't actually changed any of those. What I've done, though, is all of the new ones I've added, I've tried to make them a little bit trickier to get the master rank. Like, expert rank, I think, is very much doable in 7 years, but the master rank, we'll see. I don't think I'm going to complete this level, but we'll see how far we get. Okay, that's the first thing. So you'll see how that goes the further I get. Next thing is Crossroads, and I'm going to show you that mid-gameplay. And the last thing is AI. So the change that I've made to AI, and we'll hopefully see this, is there's a few things. I've incentivized them to go for things that no one else is making a bit more, because currently I think the AIs all kind of club together and end up making the same things. In the old version, the AIs were absolutely blind to the effects of saturation. They would eventually stop making something if they had already oversaturated and the value had gone down. But it took time, because of their lag, the inertia in the market simulation, for that effect to come to fruition. And the result of this was the AI was incredibly slow to react to this and would often build, if it had plenty of spare cash, multiple additional production lines, oversaturating a market which they were the only player in. I mean, it's just insanely stupid. It's something that a player would never do. I've now taught them how saturation works and said, stop it. Stop oversaturating. And hopefully they will. They will still oversaturate if they think it's worth it, but they will make a good judgment based on the existing saturation as to whether it's worth it, and lots of other things. One of the interesting things is now AIs don't always start with the exact same. It's interesting. AIs don't start always with the exact same ingredients that you do, so they will actually have any of the ones which are that cost one explorer, and basically if they have different ones to you, they can explore for the ones that you have for one explorer, using one explorer. Do you see what I mean? There's four different ingredients with one explorer, and me and the two AIs have a selection of three of those, so we're going to share three out of four, but there will be a slight difference, and hopefully that will add a little bit more to our diversification. It won't make such a difference on this level, but in the other scenarios where there's you only start with two ingredients, it'll just mean that there's a little bit more diversification. And what I find in the game, one of the issues with the game is that the markets are very saturated when you start, but they get less saturated as time goes on, and it means that it kind of the game gets easier the longer you're playing, and it shouldn't really be like that. I'm trying to avoid just like nerfing things. I'm trying to see what other solutions there are to this problem. So that's why I'm trying to make the AI a bit better and make it so they're better at saturating a lot more of the cures. And hopefully that will help. But you know, I'm not sure. This is actually basically the first test game, full proper test game I'm playing with the AI. You know, I like to do my testing live with you guys watching because I think it's fun. Anyway, let's get started. We'll see. I'll continue to comment on these things as we continue. Right. What should we go for? We've actually got... This is an awful draw. Look at this. I cannot make anything without hitting a side effect. So... No, that's it. I asked on Twitter what strategy I should use. Pinster and Root Negative said I should use the hipster something something opening strategy, which means that you don't go for the same ingredients as the AI. You're a hipster, so you like to roll on your own, and so basically you look at whichever is the least good. So the AIs will probably go for relieves hypertension in this circumstance, so I could go for one of the other two. They're all pretty bad in this circumstance, so who knows. But also I'm going to just like open up with, what did they say? They said open up with, I can't remember, an explorer, a scientist, and then this is quick start, so it's going to be a completely different strategy because I've already got agglomerator and ionizer. I'm going to go straight for a creamer because... look at this. This is ridiculous. I'm very tempted to go for multi-mixer 2 because that's so stupid. I haven't even got an ingredient yet to mix. Could I actually do anything clever? Interesting. I could actually avoid one of these side effects. In fact, what I could do is mix this with this, so that green one goes here, and then keep this one around, then I'd have to change the concentration a lot. Basically what I could do is try and avoid hitting a side effect by mixing two things together and basically displacing the side effect that's currently there. The problem with that is I'd be left with a very big concentration change, so it's probably not worth doing, not with a level one cure. Yeah, we'll start with just the creamer, and then I could look at getting a... Oh, I don't actually need this catalyst. Cool. We don't know which one has the level 2 catalyst. One of those should do. Right. I better start doing something. Let's just go for this one because it's going to be cheap to make. Oh, God, I forgot to mention this actually in my blog post. So I've also changed loans. It's one of the very first things I changed. Loans are now, you only start off with the three small loan companies at the beginning, and as you play for longer, you'll get access to bigger and bigger loans. Also, the interest rate is actually increases the more debt you have. So you'll see later when I no doubt will get a loan in due course, and the interest rate will jump up of the other loans when you've got debt. The point of this is to stop this strategy, which is kind of you just get all the loans instantaneously, and then, you know, you just kind of max everything out, because it's unrealistic. No lender is going to want to loan a company or an individual when they know that they've got existing debt and that you're going to, you know, get paid off last, sort of thing. So I think that makes sense. All right, let's make some cold medicine. How long do you reckon I can... Oh, I've already stopped. I was going to say, how long do you reckon I can keep up this Savandral? But the answer is No time at all. God, it feels so weird doing all this when pause. I don't really do this, but... Let's go for a couple of these. And then we'll go for this one. I've got to say, I don't normally play games with key bindings, but I'm getting used to this really quickly. And I'm actually like, well, I don't want to blow my own trumpet, but I'm kind of enjoying the key bindings. The little kind of using the numbers and tab. I don't actually use WASD. I use right mouse to scroll. Anyway, let's get some. Let's put the time on. And can I just see how things open up? Because I don't actually want to. I don't want to like overinvest and then realize like the AI is like making the same stuff I am. I'm gonna try and play most of the time with on fast speed. That's interesting. I'm gonna try and play most of the time with fast speed. See, try and get through as much of the game as I can. AI haven't made anything yet. This is good. It is kind of really harsh. The AI actually thinks and spends time building things. It doesn't need to. I can make the AI build instantly. But I do that as, like, to give the player a chance. Yet, you know, when you can just pause cheat like this, it's like, the AI is actually at a disadvantage. It's a bit strange. But not everybody pause cheats, I assume. You know, people who aren't kind of power players, people who are actually playing just to enjoy the game, you know, those people. I'm not sure if that's anybody watching. Those people might just, you know, leave it on normal speed because it's kind of nice. And I don't want to make the AI too difficult for them. We'll see. Maybe I should just make it that the AI can cheat while the player does. Like, if it's paused, the AI can build stuff too. And, like, the timer that I have, which is currently based on the tick system, could actually just be based on, like time elapsed. That'd be kind of cool. God, they've jumped straight up to angina. Haha. They did go for hypertension, but that's interesting. And you've also gone for angina. No! See, this is cool, right? Because we have a different set of starting effects, they've upgraded their warts and made a female contraceptive. Very interesting. I've already got the creamer. Gosh. I've probably been bit mad actually just letting time go quite so quickly then. God, it's already March. Right, okay, so it turns out I could have actually this whole time made, I could be upgrading all of these because I'm playing on quick start, which I kind of forgot, so that was stupid of me. Which is the best one to upgrade? Can remove that. What I could actually do is dissolver ionize, turn that into angina, and then I've noticed that this AI is got the causes pinned to needles, so I assume that angina is in a similar sort of space, I can't actually remember. But then if I do dissolver ionizer, I'll actually get this low enough that I could dissolve away my problems. So I could do that. It depends really how much the AI is going in for angina. Female contraceptive looking pretty good though. Although plus 10% demand, it's not as good as angina. No one's making antibiotics, but that's not actually the best thing here. Very interesting. Gosh, look at that. It's actually a zero-sum system, the way it works out the starting demands, and so this is actually taking a massive hit for the rest of the effects, if that makes any sense. Like, there's a reason why so many of these are positive, is that this has basically had to make up for it. It's a zero-sum system to make it balanced, but it's very much randomized in terms of how high and low things go. That's kind of cool. I'm gonna do that angina thing, because I thought that sounded quite cool. Man, I'm doing a lot of silly voices today. That's new. Something to tell my psychiatrist. Ha ha. Right. Oops. Trying to go too fast. Why do I keep doing that southern accent? I do apologize to any Americans watching. Okay. God, I'm going to have to get that loan soon, and I'll be able to show you that other feature that I forgot to mention in the blog. Okay, come on. Okay. And then the dissolver should get rid of that. Cool. So, yeah, I did actually have to do that. Good, that was a good plan. Smart moves, Wicksteed. You have to be your own cheerleader, guys. That's a little tip, by the way, from me. You need to be your own cheerleader. You know, like, people are nice, right? For the most part. But there's some dicks out there. And so, you know, whenever you get a chance to, be nice to yourself. You deserve it. You're cool. In fact, it's funny. I was actually watching Day 9. Don't know if many of you guys watch Day 9. He's a YouTuber. Used to be a pro Brood War player, StarCraft Brood War player, but now he plays a lot of Hearthstone and other stuff. But he's got this really interesting style on stream where he talks a lot to his audience just about kind of life and stuff like that. And I gotta say, it really appeals to me from a viewer perspective. I quite like his. You know, sometimes he just kind of gives life lessons. He just kind of talks about stuff. I think that's kind of cool. I'm not sure if I could put it off, but I don't know, I thought I'd mention it. I'm not actually a robot. That's the thing. I'm actually a real guy. Cool. I've got no export place because for some reason this massive plot only had one. But that does happen. But it does suck a little bit. I mean, I could run it all the way over here. I've only got 8,000 left. And then I'm still left with one extra. I'm kind of tempted to like just reduce the production of one of these just a little bit. Okay, guys, you ready for the hotshot play? Are you ready? Yeah, can you see what I'm doing? So this needs to go up one more before I get into angina territory. And I'm just going to do a little mixy doodle. So this evaporator is at least maximum efficiency, and this socket is not. Neither is this one, which is, you know, unfortunate. But you know, I'm missing an extra output socket, so at least now I get. Wait, that is actually a little stupid because this is just more valuable than the other one, and so I should just sell angina over and over again, shouldn't I? Oh, that's so interesting. That's what I'm doing. Huh. I have such a good habit of, like, finding the bugs on stream when recording. That's interesting. Export socket here is not actually working with this T-belt. Because I've done so much testing of the T-belts, and that is one edge case that I did not do. I'll get that fixed before I release this patch. That's so interesting. Like, if I put one belt between that, like, and the T-belt, that would definitely work. That's really interesting. I'm really curious about that. That's really strange, actually, that doesn't work. It's okay, because this is kind of what I want to do. I want to just make angina medication here, so that's okay. Right, what are our AIs doing? Still just making angina. How much angina? 60. You're making 60 of that. I'm making 30 of the angina. This is reaching saturation. I'm not going to make any more of that. That is not reaching. Wow, there's a lot of people need a lot of female contraceptives. Right. I'm so bad at this game, aren't I, guys? I do like the multi-mixer. Ooh, should I just go up? I think I'm just going to go straight up to autoclave, given that I can. I mean, I've been given, like, a group of cures here which don't need catalysts, so I should just go for it, right? Let's make one of each of these. Let's make some antibiotics. I should just be making, like, so much more money. Like, in fact, this is kind of crazy. Like, why am I not making more money? I shouldn't be bothering to make, like, wart medication. I should just... Given that I'm socket limited right now. Yeah, this is stupid. You're probably already thinking that, aren't you guys? This doesn't seem like a very good design. God, I wish these things butted up against one another. I'm kidding. Yeah. I find agglomerators and evaporators kind of awkward to use. It is a bit, like, it's a bit of a bad balance. I wish I hadn't done this, but I think dissolvers and ionizers are just much easier than evaporators and agglomerators to place. And I kind of wish I hadn't done that. What works quite well is, like, alternating evaporators and agglomerators one after another, but I need two in a row here, so... Okay, that'll do. If anyone would like to do, like, a forum post about, like, the most efficient ways to lay certain things one after another, I would really like to see that. Thank you. I mean, that's not so bad. It's not great, is it? Look at... Like, thing is, you know, dissolvers look super neat, but the thing is, we've actually got all this belt going around the outside, and actually, it's not that much bigger than this. I'm not going to bring up the whole things butting up against each other debate again. I think that one's been put to rest. Okay. Profit of 68, that's not that great. Well, it's a hell of a lot better than what I was making. 124. Wait a minute, let me just check some stuff. Why is this making so little? Oh, right, because it's rank E. Huh. Yeah, that'll do it. Oh, that's so interesting. God, I'm so slow. God, look at this. I didn't even realize this. I'm getting rid of that when I pass it for an evaporator, I must be. Oh, no, no, it's just, sorry, what am I, it's just that, sorry, right, the antibiotic is outside the range. So there's, like, this is so interesting. I'm still learning stuff about this game. If you start with a load of side effects that are in the same regions as your starting cures, it's totally a valid tactic to rush to level 2, because you've got a much better chance of avoiding side effects, don't you? That is much, much better. Okay, and this is making 30, which is okay, but if we upgrade this to female contraceptive... That's going to be even better, right? Okay, we're at 9. We need to get to 13. It's just agglomerator evaporator. Oh, insufficient funds. All right, let's get a loan. Which one should we go for? I generally go for the lowest interest. These are tied for lowest interest. Let's just go for the 50. Just watch this, okay? 17%, 20%, and then look at the daily payments. 223, 125. 125. Oh, that's got a lower daily payment, but it's over a longer term, so I'm still paying more interest. Let's just go for this short-term one. But yeah, 223, 125. Oh, 227, 128. That's actually not that bad. I guess you know what it is. It's only 50k, which is like the smallest amount. When you start getting bigger loans, that your interest rate will jump up more. I feel like that actually needs to be tweaked a little bit. I thought I had that nicely balanced, but I'd never really come across, like, I guess such a short, such a small loan maybe, with my testing. But I feel like that should actually jump it up a little bit more. Oh, one thing to bear in mind is actually, yeah, you're judged also on your operating profit. Yeah, no, that's why. So basically, my operating profit's actually okay at the moment, and so... it's enough to pay off that loan. So basically, if you have big loans and not a very high operating profit, that's when they start to get you for... They'll increase your interest rates. Cool. Right, so let's get this up. I want to use a crossroad. I want to do some multi-mixing because I want to show you crossroads, so I really should get that. We can afford another couple of scientists. I'm going to do, like, mass expansion now. Actually, now I've got some money. What am I doing? I haven't upgraded that yet. Ionizer. Okay. Stop. Stop. Ionizer and a dissolver. You go over there. Da-da-da-dum. I think we can fit this in, don't you? Oh, oh no, that's not quite there. Okay, sorry, slightly early. Oh, look at that. Oh, yeah. Okay. Did I just... Have they made anything else yet? Lots of malaria. Malaria needs autoclave, so that's potentially something to go for. Oh no, sorry, it needs cryogenic condenser. My mistake. Look at that. Malaria's running riot. And the thing is, malaria is actually infectious, which means the more people that have it, the higher it, the faster the increase. So we should try to make some malaria, I think. Okay, that was really weird. Just like my recording software just crashed, and I happened to notice that Fraps in the corner had stopped going red. Okay, I'm back. Sorry about that. I was just talking about malaria. I'm not going to make malaria. We're going to make some anti-malarials. I mean, look at that. That is absolutely crazy, that demand. Okay, so we definitely want cryogenic condenser. We also need to get this catalyst. I think there should be one of those in one of these two. Alternatively, we can try and go up to desert. I mean, yeah, that's another thing I want to add to the balance. I just didn't have time this time round. I think I really need to make these, or all of the non-machine ones, I need to make them all a lot cheaper in terms of scientists, make them a much more attractive to go for. They're all good, but it's like, it's strange, you always just end up going for the machines just because it's so valuable to get access to higher level machines. I mean, I don't know, I'm torn on this one, because it is obviously good, Desert Expeditions. Like, I could pretty much guarantee that I'd get the catalyst I need, but I'd need to get that first. You know, I think the trick is, I think these should be quicker. It's just like 4 months, it's just so long to wait. And you can do so much with like your starting ingredients. Right, I will have that soon, and then we go for cryogenic condenser, but I do need that ingredient. I could go for one of these right now. The problem is like, I think one of these will have a level 2 catalyst, but I don't know for sure. I don't know if I should risk it. I'm not actually making that much money yet. I really want to make malaria medication. Okay, that's making me 89. That's making me 93. That's making me 122. Right, let's just make more angina medication. This is crazy. What do I do? Dissolver, ionizer, dissolver. Dissolver. Ooh, this is wrong. Dissolver. Ionizer. Do. This isn't the best layout, but I've messed up this little section here. I guess I could have gone like this. Screw it. Okay. Dissolver. Ionizer, dissolver, agglomerator, evaporator. I'm always going the wrong way. I've got the creamer, don't I? Didn't I get that creamer ages ago and I never even used it? I'm definitely awful at this game. Did anybody else notice? Any of these got side effects? Okay, none of these are side effects, so it's not a big deal. Right, let's just... God, I've used all my money. Shit. I think it might be worth making some hypertension medication just with a creamer. At 107... Yeah, I totally think that's worth it. Wait. No one's making hypertension medication. Have they chickened out? No, they never even did. They've never even started doing that. That was my it was in my head that I thought they were going to go for hypertension medication. Cool. I've got an evaporator. Stop buying new ones. Oh, insufficient funds. Okay. Should we get another loan? It's awfully cheeky. Advanced processing. Cool. Let's go for this. Oh, I don't have enough. Well, we get some upgrades. Quite a lot of dissolvers. Quite a lot of evaporators. Quite a lot of agglomerators. I've got a real mix this time. I'm not bothering to try and do the focus strategy. I'm just going for, like, space. The thing is, I've actually got so much plant space that I really should just be using evaporators and dissolvers if I want to maximize profit. But never mind. Okay, I should actually start making some money now. Good. God, I went into debt, though. Like, overdraft debt. That should really be charged at massive interest, but it doesn't. It's not at the moment. You just can't buy anything. Which is kind of nice, it's kind of forgiving. I could have made it so that you actually had to, like, your machine stopped running, but, like, it's just so easy to do that. And, like, look, I'm obviously profitable, but if my machine stopped running, that would have ruined me with my current overheads. We have to let go when it goes up. Cool. Alright, this is going good. It's groovy. Finally starting to make some money. Like, I've got my head above the water in terms of this loan. It's 18%. You see, here's interesting. Like, again, it's my operating profit is helping keep these interest rates down. I could actually get this loan out and repay this one. But that's actually still at a higher rate, so there's no point. But it is more money. Now, let's hold off. Research complete. Multi-mixer. Okay, now I just need to get... Should I fire a couple of scientists, or should I... I guess I could just keep investing. And then get the condenser. Two. I'm going to get the analyzer. Although, no, I'm going to go for the upgrades. I'm going to have to do it. Oh god, no money. Ah, this is such a waste. Let's go for this one. Fingers crossed it's got the catalyst we need. Okay, in the meantime, what else can we be doing? Would it be more prudent to get the autoclave before the cryogenic condenser? Because then at least I could get the stroke stuff. I should have really got another ingredient. Like, I should have got this ingredient ages ago. We're taking a huge risk getting the cryogenic condenser, because we can't even use it if we don't get our catalyst. Okay, what's our times like? We've got... This is going to be done in... That's pretty quick. It's already done over 10%. This is at 15%. They're at, like, the same percentage. Alright, let's just make more of what we've already got. We've actually got enough money to support this. Okay. Oh, that's another change I made. I've actually increased the saturation limits for these things. Okay. For the level 2 ones, just felt a little bit tight. The rest of them are pretty much the same. I've actually decreased some of the saturation limits on the level 1 ones. I've done all sorts. Right. But I think it feels nicer now. The thing is, for the saturation levels to work, I really need the AI to be, like, nipping at my heels. And I've got to say that they're just both awful. I don't know what's going on. April 2016. In my tests, the AI... has, like, I mean, look, their operating profit's actually the same as mine, interestingly enough. You know what they've done? They've actually invested all their money into making just more of these good cures. I feel like I'm ahead, but actually, I'm only making 60, 90. I've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 production lines running at one speed, and he's got 4, and she's got, okay, she's got 2. She's not doing well. She's just come up with a new one. Interesting. Yeah, I think I need to speed them up a little bit, because the player's just so much quicker. I will try to do that before the next patch. It's funny, I thought they were going ever so quick, but, I don't know, May 2016, this is... Yeah. In my isolated test cases, when I'm not playing and I just put the speed on, like, 1,000% and just watch them, they're really effective, the AI. But I think they get confused by the player's actions. That's the only explanation that I've got. And they just can't compete with the speed that I've been making stuff. Okay. Let's stop that. We've got an extra socket here. We don't actually have another one, though. We could just, you know what, I'm going to use this once I get to the point when I need a mixing. That would be perfect for mixing with. Okay, is there anything else cool I can do with these ingredients? I'm already making these three. I can't make any of these. I'm waiting on a new ingredient. I could spend some points, maybe. I got 3 points. Insufficient. Oh yeah, that's right actually. Creamer, nah. Don't think it's worth spending on anything else. Good. If this doesn't have the level 2 catalyst as well as the level 1, I'm gonna be so annoyed with myself. Because this update's actually going on quite long. I kind of want to show you stuff. Let's see how I'm doing. I'm actually nowhere near my total revenue. 5 years remaining. I'm not doing very well, am I? I'm not even gonna get. I'm nowhere near. Jesus, I'm doing awfully. But if we get that malaria, man, if we get that malaria. Okay, well, let's just get some more loans. This is like, let's just expand. That, how much was that second one? 22. That's okay. Interest rate 44. Oh, you know what? I think that's interesting. I swear that interest rate went down. I guess it might be to do with my operating profit. I'm not really sure. I'll have to look into loans again. Liver trouble away. Ooh, that's a good cure. Liver disease. Okay, fair enough. Not bad. They're competing with me on the antibiotics. Right. Let's stop the clock. That's not quite a saturation. These are all getting quite saturated. Huh, they've gone for that. Oh, I get it. So this is where patents will come in interesting. This has already got the catalyst present, which is just sick. That's just like, oh, I love it when that happens. Okay. Let's go for dissolver. Do, do, do. Oh, okay. Dissolver, dissolver, dissolver. Do, 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 do. Okay, let's pause again. I'm not going to make too much of this gout medication because they're already making it. Sorry, not the gout, the liver disease. These are all pretty saturated. In fact, that one is lasty. Starting to go down. I could just make some gout medication. Yeah. Oops, I don't know why I did that. Oops, too much flicking. Let's try again. Okay. It's funny, on the forum recently, I saw someone say, like, the creamer is so useless. And it's funny, because for ages I thought the creamer was really overpowered. So, it's good. It makes me just realize that, basically, it's all about your strategy. And, actually, the game isn't too imbalanced. Like, I don't, like, there are certain things that make the game kind of easier, things you can do, but in terms of the stuff in the game, I don't think there's like any one machine that's overpowered. But the syringe maker is very effective, but it's incredibly expensive, really annoying processing time, takes up so much space. Like, it's not everything for sure. Okay. Oh, and I didn't even make this. Okay, so that's upgraded. Oh wow, okay, look, we gotta get this much higher. I think that's the annoying thing, is I'd like to be able to not have that space there. But the only way to do agglomerate is, effectively, is to have that space. Erectile dysfunction. Cool. Maybe I can make some more bumper erecto. This always goes down well. Can we get rid of this? No. Okay. Okay, great. Pause. Do do ba dum dum ba dum da ba dum. dum 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 da ba da ba dum. Bum 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 ba da bum. Okay, so we have this one spare and we have this one spare. Haven't done this very well, have you, Tim? Anyway, we'll use both of those for mixing stuff anyway. Great. I might need the shaker, you never know. No, let's go for deserts. I don't want to risk it. Let's get all these things. And use our upgrade points. I'm going to put a little indicators down here, by the way, guys, for showing your upgrade point numbers. Like, I'm not sure where. Like, to the left of the dollar sign. Like, there and there. So I know that's what people really want, to be able to see that upgrade point on the main screen, and I totally understand, and I am going to give you that. Let's get ready to rumble. Okay. How's our ingredients doing? So we're using our gout. We've already, like, maximized that. We need this. Need to get ahead of this AI. Man, do better. Come on, man. Disappointed. Given that this update was, like, meant to be about AI. I haven't even shown you Crossroads yet. Okay, I will show you Crossroads when we get to some more, like, two-speed stuff. Did anyone see my GIF? Like, the autoclaves running at maximum speed. And you cross the input of one over the output of the other or something like that, and it's... Ugh, it's wicked. Maybe we should analyze this. Make some really good liver... Given that we're going to have to do it with a side effect, I'm just tempted to, like, analyze half of our liver disease stuff. Haha, interesting. Yeah, that's fine. That does mean that we're definitely going to be hitting some saturation with this. Oof. You bitch. Yes! Okay, wicked. Let's get going. I think I want the money. I think I might... No, you know what? I'll wait and get some... Huh. It's interesting. These are... Prices aren't going up very much of these. I guess they're starting to go above net demand soon now. I think I might have to make these more saturated. It's funny. Like, I'm... I guess that's a little bit higher. I'm used to these being higher. I think in Quick Start, it's interesting, because you start with three ingredients. You just don't feel... You don't saturate the markets as quickly, because you only start with the same amount of money, but you split that between more cures. And so you just... Yeah, you've just got a lot less pressure pushing stuff up. Anyway. Alright, it's time to make something sick. We have all of the ingredients. Oh, do we need the shaker? Yeah, that's interesting. I'm not sure... Oh, God. Okay. We can get an ingredient out here. do we need the shaker? We might do, yes. We're making malaria, right? Which is soothes cold symptoms. No, we don't. Awesome. Okay, so... Where's our antibiotic? Don't tell me this was making antibiotics. No, that's our angina. Contraceptive, antibiotic. Okay, so we could just feed this one out. Or we could get a new one. No, that we need one of these for an export. So, yeah, we are just going to have to feed this out. We're going to... this is not perfect. We could just use... Nah, let's do this. We need all this space for the multi-mixers anyway. We're just going to leave these running, because these should still get sucked down. Yeah, good. Okay. Right. Antibiotic. Ah, cool. It's already got the right concentration. And then we just need to bring in our new thing. Ah, it's exciting. Ah, I love mixing stuff. Okay. Right. Here we go, guys. You ready for Crossroads? I gotta remember how to do it. I think this will work. So what's interesting, you can actually cross over the input or the output. Like, the rule with Crossroads is basically, as long as it's a two-speed line that you're crossing over, it will run with perfect efficiency. If it's a one-speed line, it's not going to run with perfect efficiency. Like, find another way of doing it. Like, it's only one-speed lines that you can't cross over, so it's like, there's nearly always a layout that you can use. You know, like, you wouldn't want to cross over these lines because that would mess it up. And so instead, I kind of rearrange my sockets to allow for this. But, yeah, anyway. So, oh, got that wrong. So this is now connected to that entrance, to that entrance. This is connected to that entrance. We need to connect it to this one. So what you do with the crossroads is you can't drag right through because it sends the, like, it's no, you can't do a very clever pathing system if you drag it right through, because how would the computer know the difference between dragging right through and dragging all the way around? It's like, for example, if you drag here, if it's an empty space, it'll always try and drag away all the way around. But if you drag into something, it will know that that's what you mean. So to do a crossroad, you drag here, you make a T-junction, and then you drag again, right? And that makes a crossroad. Okay? And that should work. And then all you have to do is connect up the outputs. That input is on top. So that's going to be... Yep, that's right, I think. No. Oh shit, have I fucked this up? I need to remove this. I keep getting mixed up with ingredients. So this can go here, but it's not a gap, so it won't work without a shaker, unless I remove that. Or, no, I can't remove that one. Yeah, okay. I need to remove that if I'm going to do this without a shaker. Fuck. Okay, evaporate. Okay. That should work. Gonna have just to make sure. Right, that's 11. If I bring that up to 13, right? 14, okay, and then evaporate it. Extra sound effects. Okay, we found this testing strength of Induces Nightmares. there was a pill in there which I hadn't sold yet. That's funny. That will not work. I'm just gonna get rid of that. Okay. So that goes on top. Right. Right. Okay, great. Unfortunately, it does mean we're gonna have to have all these things too. It's okay. We got the shaker! Well, like 2 minutes too late, but hey, it's okay. Right, so, this is just, like, I want to show you this, is interesting. Like, this is holding up right now because its output is blocked. And the way crossroads work is they're different to splitters. They don't always run when they can, because the key thing with a crossroad is you never want to mix your streams. So if you've got something in the way, this won't be able to get through until that moves off. But whenever they can, they will switch. If you have a crossroad, okay, imagine this green one wasn't there and all you had was the blue one, then the blue one would be able to go fine. So it's like, if it can travel, if it can get right through, it will just keep on going. But in this circumstance, basically, it's actually blocking because the place that it wants to get to has a thing in it. Once it all starts moving, it will become 100% efficient, because basically this will move in, and this will go there, and then this will move in, and it'll just line up perfectly. You'll see. Okay. And then we get our thing with this. Okay, then we just need to get it down to 11 to upgrade it. So we're going to go for a 1-3. Wait, this is stupid. Right, that will get us to, okay, then we need a dissolver. And then we need our, please don't tell me I've like fucked something up, like, that is right, yeah, cryogenic condenser, I have read it right. Okay, god, I suddenly just like worried that I meant autoclave. If we want to keep this at perfect speed, we're going to need two of these. Oh, you know, I'll show you the other way of doing these things, where you can cross the input over the output. It's kind of cool. We're going to need to have that down there to make this work, I think. So what you can do is we cross this like that. I'll wait to see if we've got side effects that we can get rid of or something like that. We might, or if we need to. But basically what will happen is this will go in here, and then the second ingredient will come across to here. And then you actually put a crossroad on the output there. And again, because these are two speed, that this will run perfect efficiency and you'll just get it here. So there's just loads of different ways of laying things out now. And I'm pretty, you know, this will work for free speed too. I did some crazy thing with an atomic sequencer. The only issue with the atomic sequencer is you needed, like, a bit of extra space to kind of make things work, because you need a bit of a runway. Like with the two speed, you only need like a runway of one after the crossroad. In fact, you don't even need a runway of one with the two speed, but the three speed you do. You end up, yeah, things just start getting like snarled up, yeah, because of this thing where if you've got something already on a crossroad, it can't move. All right, let's watch this in all of its beauty. Okay, this is just waiting for it to come through. Okay, I'm just going to watch this for a little bit. Just let you guys see how it's all working. So the greens always go here and here, and the blues always go here and here. And this is 100% efficient, and this is climbing up to 100%. It was just a little bit late getting started. Okay, we've tested our liver disease. Oh, we're already on the max for liver disease, that's fine. Okay. So I think we've already got, yeah, max liver disease, never mind. Didn't need that. But yeah, that is now 100% efficient. Which is kind of awesome. Look at the crossroad! It goes in, and then it goes in, but then this one moves there, so it doesn't slow down. Okay, let's see if this one's working. So this is the output. Now this moves here, but it will move out of the way just in time for when this comes out. Didum. And then this will move out of the way just in time for this one to come across. And it's basically hella cool. That was weird. That one waited there for a second. Why is this waiting? Oh, that's so interesting. Huh, okay. I'm going to have to make a note of that. That is actually a little bit strange. This one should keep moving even when this path isn't open. That's very... that does actually make complete sense. That's so interesting. Huh. Okay, yeah. I might tweak that. I might not. It kind of works the way it is. One sec. Just going to pause. Okay, anti-malarial. We can get rid of this. Oh, that's annoying. We've just passed it through one of those to upgrade, but there's no way that the two things don't overlap, do they? 11, 9. But we need that. Shit, yeah. And then that doubles it. That's actually a real pain to get rid of. I think we're just going to have to make this a cream. We run out of space anyway. I've actually made awful use of this space. -3, -3, -3, -3. We're going to go one into the anti-malarial. It might get us a little bit further away from the max strength, who knows. Might get us closer to the strength of that one. Cool. All right, let's go. And then I'm going to move to a new factory to make another one. Anti-malarial! Current profit 201. So yeah, I have rebalanced things, and you know what? It's feeling pretty good, right? Because liver disease is pretty good. The problem with liver disease, though, is is once you cure it, and it will tail off pretty quick. Okay. Where's the anti-malarial? Help you snore. Whereas this anti-malarial has really high demand at the moment. Again, once we cure that, it will cure it. And it's only making us 203. So that feels about right. Like, I think before there was this thing with like the first level free cure that you got would like you'd just suddenly have so much money. So this is feeling a little bit nicer. Like, I feel like I'm doing well out of this, but I'm not gonna do like crazy good. And eventually I'll cure too much of malaria and the price won't be high anymore. Oh shit, if we go down one more, we can actually make it so it's cough medicine too. Let's do that. Shit, I'm gonna have to get rid of some stuff. Shit. Come on. Is that not going anymore? Yeah, I guess I should change that. That's a bit crappy. Like, that's not gonna go now until... Right. We have to... I don't want to waste this malaria, because they're worth quite a lot. So I'm just gonna do this to clear off these... I'm gonna make sockets suck by default, because it's stupid. Yeah, what I've currently got. It does make a lot of sense in terms of like the reasons that I chose made them not do that, but I'm just gonna kind of hack it. So the reason I didn't make them do that in the first place was because oh dear, messed this one up too. Okay, I need to wrap this up soon. We're coming on for an hour, in fact, very close to an hour now. So the reason sockets don't suck by default is that you need to be able to click a socket. Like, sorry, let's take this off, right? This is now not connected to anything, so you need to be able to click it to import an ingredient. So, and if you start a new base over here, right, and then you draw some belts out of it, you know, you should be able to click that to start a new ingredient. And this is, for all intents and purposes, the game doesn't know that this is any different to... this line here, because it's not connected to anything, right? So that's the reason. But what I'm going to do is basically I'm going to make this suck. So this is, if it's connected to any belt, it will act as an export. But it's a bit different to, say, this export, where if you click on it, it shows you the what it's exporting. If it's not actually got anything that it's exported, then you can click on it to import something. So here, this will be sucking, but you'll also be able to click on it to tell it to export something, import something. So it is a little bit wonky. So I had a good reason not to do that, but basically I have to have something that acts as both an import and an export in a strange way, which is weird. But I'll just hack it because it has a very good use case, and that's, you know, I'm all about the playability, believe it or not. Oh, I love the colors. Blue turns to green. All right. I wonder if I could make another one of these lines, but just like much more compact, because I've got it like snaking along. I could make that so much smaller. Okay. Yeah, look at that, 279. So yeah, what I was saying a minute ago about, the balance wasn't quite right in terms of just high level stuff just seemed a bit too good. There is something strange going on, which is not strange, but like something to be aware of, which is that malaria isn't meant to be worth that much. It is meant to be worth less than many things that are the same level as it. But the key thing with malaria is that it's very infectious, and so if you wait long enough, there'll be a big demand for it. So, you know, this is only worth this much when it's 40% up, so it wouldn't be that much. But if we look at these ones, which are more kind of like normal kind of amounts, we're still, it's a similar value. You're not really looking at more than about 200 profit, which is right for a level 3. Like, you shouldn't be making more than that on a level 3. And I think before you were too often. Okay, let's just finish off by maximizing our profit and see, nowhere near. 4 years remaining. I mean, we are going to hit standard quite easily. Let's maximize our profits. These guys should have really been working. Skin. Do we want to go for skin? Yeah. Okay. Let's go for that. I quite like making acne cream. Right. Where was I? I've got to end this What are you guys doing? A particularly dry monsoon season has caused the population of mosquitoes to fall dramatically. The resulting decrease in these malaria disease-carrying pests is falling. No! The irony! I don't know if that's irony or just bad luck. Okay. Let's upgrade this. And let's upgrade this. Wait, what are we getting the most of? We're getting 30 of that. We're getting 60 of that. 30 of that. 90 of that. 30 of that. Okay, we can't upgrade that again. Okay, and then we need to upgrade machines. Yes, I probably should have got this, shouldn't I, earlier. Doll. I'm an idiot. At least I got Desert Expeditions. Uh, 19 points, huh? Oh gee, that's a fair bit. Oh gee, you betcha. Yeah, because I'm gonna make loads of malaria stuff. I'm gonna make the analyzer zero process cost, but then if you upgrade it, you get an increased analyze rate, which is someone suggested on the forum. It's a great idea. It means that it's free if you want to use it like an incinerator. It also means it's not quite as annoying when you like leave the analyzer running without realizing. Yeah, it does still, it would still consume your drugs though, which is a bit of a bad thing. I'm not sure. Maybe you know, that's on you, just to keep an eye on things. There might be some other solution, like it not running when you've already analyzed everything. But the problem with that is then if you're using it as an incinerator, then it will stop running after a while. So I think the first thing is just let's not make it so it has a process cost. So at least it's just free to eat stuff. But when it's analyzing, you get the bonus. Because currently I never upgrade this. All right. Let's just leave this running for a little bit and then see what our operating profit's like. No, yeah, it's not our profit, sorry, revenue. So look, 500k a year does mean that we will definitely hit that in the next 4 years. But we're actually way off the expert rank. So I've definitely made this harder. I've made some misplays for sure. I've got loads of money in the bank I could have spent quicker. And I've been chatting a lot. So yeah, I think, I mean, I might be able to hit expert if I really, really, like, ramp up my production in the next half of this game. Because I'm less than halfway still. But, yeah, master is definitely going to be very tricky to achieve. This is, look, my, yeah, the malaria is now, like, look, it is, like, don't get me, like, that is wicked. 400, like, 200 a day is really, really good. Interesting, this is actually a lower rank. Oh, how interesting. This is... The urinary retention is actually worse with the second one. And it's not such a good malaria cure. How interesting. Maybe we should have left it with the first one. But it's still making more money because it's stopping people coughing. But yeah, look at... Our malaria is now, like... It's dropping quite rapidly, the demand for it. So, you know, you do have to be quite careful. I mean, one tactic is actually to not make a very good malaria cure, and it means that it doesn't drop the demand as quickly. Like, 30 malaria cases cured, 100 malaria cases cured, that's a third, that's, sorry, three quarters. This is, yeah, just under three quarters. See, what we could do is deliberately move, I think the max strength is either where it is here, or it's 15. Concentration, and what we could do is move this down again to 12. It means we probably have less of a side effect. It might be more of a side effect if the max strength happens to be in that last square of the urinary retention. But the main thing is, by selling a worse product, we actually decrease the rate that it's being cured, and we can keep our profits higher for longer. Yeah, you can be that much of a dick. Okay, guys, I'm going to wrap up this video here. Thank you very much for watching. I hope you enjoyed hearing about the new ranking system, which we didn't actually get to hit any of the ranks, but you know, you can see how that will work. the Crossroads and the AI, and indeed the loans, which I think were okay. I might have another little look at them. Please let me know what you think of the, like, the balance of these things. Like, you know, tell me if the loans don't, if the interest rate's not going up enough. I mean, I felt like that was very fair in this game. Like, the loans weren't prohibitively expensive, but they also weren't prohibitively, they weren't too cheap. And the fact that you can't just get a 300k loan out for, off the bat definitely meant I didn't have so much cash hanging around. Cool. Alright, I am going to stop this game and I'm going to save it because I'm going to come back and play it some more later. And thank you for watching, and I will see you next time. Bye-bye.